The waves slide upon the sand. Every ripple obeys the last command. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
How you doing today, brothers and sisters?
الحمد لله.
Today is day number 6. As you recall, yesterday we were talking about the relationship between the father and the son. Surah number 12, verse number 5.
Alhamdulillah. As you know, that Prophet Yaqub al-Islam at the end of that verse tells Prophet Yusuf al-Islam to not tell his brothers about the dream. But at the end also, he talks about the shaitan. And that is going to be our topic for today. Shaitan is an open enemy of human beings. And this is exactly what Prophet Yaqub al-Islam tells his son. The most important advice that a father should give his child is to watch out for his worst enemy. And the worst enemy that we have is none other than the shaitan himself. So today, let's discuss a little bit about shaitan and his characteristics. Why is it that there are so many problems in the world today? What do you think the most important thing that we should be blaming for that?
Well, for sure the shaitan. Because if we kind of like go back in time and rereading the Quran, we will know that the shaitan did promise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he will send every single creation that Allah creates astray. He will lead them all astray.
Yep.
And he will try his best, his outmost best to do that.
So what that tells you is that shaitan, first of all, it might sound like he's very strong, but in fact he's very weak. It all depends on how we view it.
Exactly.
So the way we have to look at it is, if you think about it, the shaitan, the most he can do is whisper to you about, you know, doing something haram. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم.
Exactly. Do you guys know what that means?
I seek refuge in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the accursed shaitan.
Now what that does is it automatically sends the shaitan away. He goes home running. He was like, I'm scared.
Well, thank you. I don't know if it happens in that manner, but alhamdulillah, we know that in Ramadan Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala locks up the shaitan, but that does not mean that he has not worked on your soul all year long. So you still have that nafs, your internal desires to fight. So even in Ramadan, you have to fight those desires and know that after Ramadan, he's coming right back to hunt us down. So we have to be ready for all of his planning and tricks. But here's the thing, it's very easy. Prophet ﷺ tells us to recite, for example, Ayatul Kursi before you go to sleep, to recite the Qul, Qul huwa Allahu Ahad, Qul a'udhu birabbil falaq, Qul a'udhu birabbin nas, the last two verses of Surah Baqarah. He tells us to say A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim whenever some bad thought comes to our mind. There's so many ways to protect ourselves. The Quran itself is the best way to protect ourselves from the shaitan. So in this month, inshallah, most of us are reading the Quran. That in itself is a protection from the shaitan. Now, the next and final advice for you guys is to understand that shaitan is not strong. He's only as strong as
you make him to be.
So, for example, if he was to come and force you to do a sin, then the whole purpose of shaitan is defeated, because he wants to make sure that on the day of judgment you have no excuse. So he never comes and forces you to do a sin. All he does is whispers. So sometimes human beings could be even worse than shaitan, because they could actually come and force you and poke you and be like, bro, come on, man.
Do it.
Let's go to
do
the
it.
Club, man.
Dumb.
Come on, man. It's just one drink, bro. Just do it. Come on, man. You can do
it. Ah, man, my shoulder.
Oh. So you see what I'm saying? The human beings can actually hurt and force others to do a sin. But the shaitan doesn't even do that. All he does is whispers. On the day of judgment, it will be asked about what we did to protect ourselves from the shaitan. And all he could do was whisper to us. As we know in Surah Nas, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says at the end of the surah, من الجنة والناس, the shaitan, it could be from human beings and from the jinn. Now the main shaitan, which is Iblis, is from the jinn. But human beings can also become an army or agents of helping the shaitan. There's so many human beings that they fall for their desires and they could literally become the friends of shaitan and promoting his evil plots onto the rest of the world. So for us, it's very important to know that this Ramadan, we must try to defeat this enemy by going under the shelter of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The enemy itself is strong, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the creator, and he knows what's best for us. So we need to return back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, protect you from the shaitan.
Ameen. Inshallah. Ameen.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
How are you doing today, brothers and sisters?
They can't respond back, but alhamdulillah.
Alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah. All right.
Day number 6.
This is day number 6, as we previously known that yesterday.
Previously known that yesterday.
We're talking about the relationship between the father and son. Surah number 5. We're going to continue off the surah.
Surah number 12, verse number 5.
Sorry, no, it's not. All right. Sorry, we're going to. Today, we're going to continue off the surah. And as you recall, Omar, can you please read it?
Yes. So, as you recall, that Prophet Yusuf alayhi salam was... Come on. Is verily the shaitan is the man's open enemy.
When Allah sent him to hell, he told him that he will try his best, his utmost best, to stray every single creation that he creates the way of Allah.
I didn't get that.
I know what I'm saying.
Jazakallah khair, though. It was a good attempt. Alhamdulillah.
The waves slide upon the sand. Every ripple obeys Allah's command. Ocean shimmering shades of blue. Mysteries if only we.